Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to your favorite girl on the internet. That's me, by the way. If you are new here, my name is Jasminerossette and I film weekly videos of my weight loss journey, showing you guys what I eat, how I work out, everything. I spill the tea, I tell you everything. Today is Monday. It is currently 7:56, so I need to get started on this workout so I can be ready. Hopefully finish taking a shower by 8:30 this morning. Before we get into that, last week I finished off weighing 217.1, which is really exciting. I began the week on Monday 219.8 because on Saturday and then Sunday I ate a lot of chips and salsa, which caused me to gain a lot of weight very quickly. Getting back down, as you guys saw in the confessional, the little confession session, I did have ice cream. So we went on this hike with a bunch of people. Food was prepared beforehand and thought of beforehand, and I was just not in that process. So I had two slices of pizza, dairy-free pizza. Everyone else had like regular pizza because they ordered in, and then I, along with two other people, had shared this small pizza from Daya, D-A-Y-D-A-I-Y-A, which is a brand that you can buy at King Soopers, Walmart, I'm pretty sure, Target, and Whole Foods as well. But it's just like dairy-free and gluten-free products. And so we had a dairy-free, gluten-free pizza, which was really nice. And then I was also given a dairy-free ice cream bar and had some of that. So, and also the person who prepared the food as well for me and the other person who had dietary restrictions made us cookies along with peanut butter and jelly sandwiches and stuff like that. So I ate it and they were really good. And I really appreciated them making food for me and this other person for our hike that day. Yeah, I ended up tracking basically 12,000 steps. It was awesome. So that is the reason why I ate ice cream, I had cookies, but it was in moderation, and yeah, back to eating as clean as possible. But as I said, I was not in control. I thought about getting lunch, but then I was texted saying like, oh, like we have lunch prepared for you and stuff like that. Because usually like if I'm going with a group, I try to prepare my own meals just because, or like buy something that's gonna be like lactose intolerant friendly, dairy free friendly for myself. Just because sometimes people just don't remember and I don't want to like not have food on a day that we're hiking. So I was like, oh, I'm gonna prepare my lunch and dinner and stuff like that. And I also didn't realize that we were having dinner there. I don't know why. But I had prepared my breakfast. I had like my oatmeal like I normally did, along with some snacks that were like bananas, carrots, mixed nuts, salmon jerky, and stuff like that. But anyways, I digress. That was the reason why I had the ice cream and cookies. Also, yesterday was kind of a cheat meal for me. Yesterday, I had crawfish. Well, I didn't have crawfish, I had shrimp. But it's a place where you go to get like a crawfish boil. So I had shrimp instead with some like Cajun seasoning and sourdough bread. And that was so delicious. And then I also had a mango kale smoothie from Smoothie King. So that was like my cheat slash treat yourself moment. They're healthy options, but still like it's not an everyday occurrence type of thing to have those things. So I planned my next cheat meal this coming weekend, which I think I would like to have Shake Shack, but I'm gonna have like a chicken sandwich. I never really go beef burgers type of thing. I typically like when I get there, I'm like, oh, I'd rather just have like a chicken sandwich. So I'm gonna have like a chicken sandwich and maybe some fries and do the chicken sandwich and like a lettuce wrap. I think they have sweet potato fries. I'll probably go for that as well. So it's just like an overall healthier option, but yeah, I might do that. Anyways, also another update. I feel like an official YouTuber because I got a Lacey. My computer was running out of storage, so I needed to get an external hard drive. And I got this one at Best Buy. It holds 2 terabytes, which is great. Which when something says it holds like 2 terabytes or it's 186 gigabytes or whatever, there's gonna be like parts of it left out. So it's really like 1.7 terabytes, but that's more than enough. And I was able to put like a lot of footage that I've done from previous YouTube videos and photos and stuff like that and put it on here. Also, I'm working on becoming better at doing thumbnails. So thumbnails will get better going forward. So don't you worry. I am just trying to make everything a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. But anyways, it is probably 8 o'clock now. It's 8:01 and I need to work out. So I'm gonna do that, do a little ab exercise, do like basically a full body exercise this morning, full body workout. Let us get into it. I just made my lunch. I made some ramen with some stir-fry vegetables and shrimp that I kind of burnt a little, as you can see. Crispy. I hate when I burn food. Anyway, let me show you the ramen. There is the ramen that I made along with my stir-fry vegetables. I'm probably gonna just have half of that, just because I don't think I wanna eat all of that, and I think I'll have the other half at like for lunch tomorrow. So I have something to look forward to. I ended up finishing the ramen, which was really good, but means I'm not gonna have any snacks today, so it's not a bad thing. Just have my hot water bottle, keep it to warm my feet because it's a little chilly. The dish in the sink moved. Anyways, finished lunch and gotta get back to work now. I have some meetings that I've set up with people that I gotta, you know, meet with. Also, really exciting news, the video that I posted, the title is called Food Poisoning from Cereal, and I think it's like the second week of me doing these weekly vlogs, and it's like so close to 100 views on YouTube, and I'm just like, oh my gosh, what is happening? I don't understand what's happening, but it's really cool. It's just, yeah, the fact that I got 100 views on that, I was just like, what? So it's making me like, seeing that, I'm just like, okay, I gotta up my thumbnails, because like the banner and the intro outro is already different now. I think I have my intro song, my outro song, I think I have that, but I need to get like more, you know, different types of music. I need to find more music on SoundCloud. But yeah, I was just, this is wild. I couldn't believe it. Also, I washed my mask that I wore on Saturday with dish soap, and I got like basically a rash because of it on my lips. So like the corners of my mouth are like extremely cracked. And so I've been putting AND ointment and Neosporin on it to help, because it's just been so incredibly painful. But anyways, I'm just really excited that like that video's gotten almost 100 views. I like saw it this morning not thinking anything of it, because I got a comment on my video, and I get notified when I get comments. Well, sometimes I get notified. So there are times when my notification doesn't let me know when I get a comment on video, and it'll be weeks, and then I'm like, oh, someone commented, I need to comment back. Someone commented on my video and I responded, and then I saw the views on that video and I was just like, 84, 84 views. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, this is wild. I didn't do anything besides make that, you know. Yeah, I mean, I didn't do anything to my channel. So I'm just like, I don't know how I'm getting like noticed, but I'm very excited and very thankful for all the views. So I'm really appreciative. Like, that's the most views that I've ever gotten on a YouTube video. And I was just like, oh my gosh, it makes me nervous, but also very excited. Anyways, I am going to get back to work now. It is 1:33. I've been gone for 30 minutes, so let's get this bread, shall we? So I am about to head out right now for about a 20-minute walk. It's pretty nice and cool outside, so I'm gonna just put on a jacket and my sneakers and like listen to some music and just go on a walk in the neighborhood. So I'm gonna try to remember to stretch afterwards and hopefully show that to you guys. So I will see you later. Good morning, guys. I am eating in bed my breakfast, kind of late. It's 9:54, about to be 10 o'clock. I have my green juice with collagen peptide, celery juice, actually. Yeah, kind of having like a little bit of a rough week at work, but I just have to push through, get better, improve on some things, and it will be fine, God's willing. So yeah, I have a meeting in a couple minutes here, just trying to get in a few bites before I meet with this person, because I forgot to make breakfast earlier. That's always like the downside of working in bed, is that my like eating times start a lot later. Eating time. That's such a weird thing to say. But yeah. Also, update on the Hannibal show. I started watching the 3rd season. I'm not liking it as much as the rest of the other 2 seasons, but I do know that it gets canceled, so there's only 3 seasons. But I'm not really looking forward to finishing the 3rd season, because I feel like it's going in a direction that it just seems kind of out of the blue to me, and it doesn't really make sense, but we'll see. So I am having a hard mental day, basically. Need to unplug my computer. But I really wanted to order food. I thought about grabbing Chipotle or something, but didn't really want to pay. So I'm just going to make some food and just hopefully make it tasty enough that it satisfies, essentially. But yeah, I'm having not the best mental day. Got in my head about some stuff, and there's always like room for improvement in life and in all areas and aspects of life. And I get that, I understand that. It just can be hard, like, taking that, as well as understanding you need to improve. And it's only for the betterment of yourself, but also at the end of the day, it's like for the benefit of the people that are around you as well. And when you hear it from other people who this is going to benefit, it can just be challenging and hard. So yeah, it's just felt like the past 2 days I've been told like areas to improve on, and I just have been pretty hard on myself about it. I'm going to make green beans with some chicken and egg and goat cheese. That is going to be my lunch today. But I really wanted to like grab sushi or get Chipotle or have, I don't know, Chick-fil-A for lunch. But looking at the delivery fees, I was just like, I don't want to have to like wait and go out. It'll be a lot faster if I just make it. And then I kind of just contemplated and debated, and now I'm just making my food. So currently making the green beans right now. A lid on that, and then I will go into frying up my egg with the chicken. Despite having not the best like mental day, I still ate healthy, which was great. Usually when I'm like not doing well mentally, or I'm like down about something or upset, it's my first thing is to just go towards food. I deal with my emotions by eating food that I know is not like the best for me, or just food that's like, you know, not even just not that, that it's not the best for me. I just enjoy eating comfort food because it's called comfort food for a reason. It comforts me when I am not feeling my best, or I'm not feeling positive, or I want to avoid a problem. Whatever it may be, comfort food is comforting for me because I'm able to focus on something that's really good through taste. And allow that to kind of like help me feel better because I'm eating something that tastes really good. Hi.
Okay, it's Jasmine.
Hi.
I know it's prime time. Girl, I was already on my little thing, mm-hmm. my this morning looking at stuff. Mm-hmm. I really didn't see much of anything that I would want. But I saw the Echo 8. Is it $40-some?
Sorry, I had a call and then I had to hop into a meeting because I needed help with something. But anyways, as I was saying earlier, I noticed that it was just very interesting to see that for myself, I like really do go to food first to deal with my problems and to kind of comfort me when I'm not able to like have better coping skills, to comfort myself in a way. I start thinking about this weight loss, and I have a few years off before I'm in my 30s, but still, like, I think in my mind, like, subconsciously, I'm just like, I should have it together, or I should be able to have a house by now and, like, be able to lose the weight and not, you know, do these things that I'm self-sabotaging myself. And it's just like, I start to think of them in ways that are childish, and it's just me realizing that it's not childish to understand that my coping mechanism of processing how I'm feeling or working through my emotions is by immediately going to food that is comforting, which at the same time is not beneficial for me right now on my weight loss journey. If I was trying to maintain weight, that's fine, but I'm trying to lose weight. So obviously going to comfort food, getting burgers and fries and eating very greasy foods or eating an abundance of foods or even having ice cream and cookies and all that stuff, those are not inherently bad foods, but at the same time, like on this weight loss journey, those foods are not helping me towards my goal. And because I realized that, I think that the act of self-sabotage is childish, or the fact that I should be mature enough to be able to lose the weight because I am an adult, or be able to own a home right now because I am at a certain age in my life as an adult. And indeed, it is not childish. It is just being human. And I have to make sure that I'm no longer associating childish behavior and being human as equaling the same thing, because they don't. I didn't mean to like try to get deep about that, but yeah, I'm just like thinking about how I process things and deal with my emotions and process through like challenging times or slightly difficult situations. And the thing is, like, what I'm dealing with in terms of like the constructive feedback is not bad, but as I was talking to my grandma earlier, as you guys saw, like, she mentioned, like, it does seem like it probably hurt your ego, and I was very quick to answer yes, which I was a little bit surprised at how fast I answered that, but yeah, it's true. Like, I pride myself on doing things well and being a good worker, but I have noticed that, or even like, and being a good friend, or, you know, I pride myself on doing things well and doing them so well that like no one questions them. But at the same time, I have this complex when people do tell me that, like, when people tell me that I'm very goal oriented and I seem perfect, in those moments when someone's complimenting me, I can't see that because I take that compliment as a negative. But internally for myself and how I act and how I know myself, I feel like, yes, that is the expectation. That is how I act because I know that this is the best way to be. This is just getting too deep right now. I feel like if I talk more, I just need to like journal more. I feel like this entire like week has just, which it's only Tuesday, so it's like not even an entire week yet. It's only the beginning. But so far, I'm just realizing that I just need to journal and process my feelings by writing it down. Because me talking it through, it is helpful. But at the same time, like, I do need to be careful with how much I give of myself online. That I just did, and I really, really like this one. Definitely gonna keep it in the rotation. That one was a really good workout, and yeah, I think I'll do that in the mix with what I already do on my own. But I really liked this circuit. It was really good. I really should stretch more because honestly, I feel amazing after stretching. I feel really good. Also, that workout that I did before, it was only like, the video is 16 and a half minutes, so it's not long at all, the workout, but it like causes you to sweat. Even if you're doing the modified version or if you take a little bit of a break, it still causes you to sweat, which is really good, and it gets the heart pumping, which I like, and I like the fact that it used weights. So that one was a really good workout to me. I really liked that workout. It wasn't super difficult. I was still able to breathe through it. I could have pushed myself more if I wanted it to be a little bit more challenging, but I felt the pace that I was going was perfect because I was going for slow, controlled movements, which I achieved. That's kind of like what I'm trying to do when I'm doing workouts with weights, is doing slow, controlled movements, because then I find my form is a lot better, but also I am just working out the muscle more efficiently and more effectively, and I can do it full out. Instead of just doing quick, rapid reps, I do slow, controlled, so then I get the full extension. Instead of just doing this, I can just go forward, and then I get more areas that are targeted when I'm going slow and controlled. So yeah, and then I just did my own stretching routine, although Mr. and Mrs. Muscle have stretching routines on their YouTube channel, so I'm sure you could find some and follow along. I definitely need to stretch more because that felt really good to just get loose, and also foam rolling. So now that I know this feeling, I definitely got to hold on to it a little bit more, and I think stretching immediately after working out is key. I will see you guys tomorrow morning for another workout. I think I'm gonna try to wake up a little bit earlier and possibly go for a walk, because walking during the fall time has been, the couple times that I've done it, along with the two hikes that I've done, have been really great, minus the last hike that I did. I was very gassy and my stomach hurt and I wasn't able to release the gas. You know those painful getting your stomach that just stays stuck there? That's how I was on that hike last Saturday. It was just not fun. When you're trying to breathe, you're getting like a little bit of fatigue and you're trying to breathe through it. The pain of the gas in your stomach just makes it a little bit more impossible. So you're just like not having fun. But it was still a good hike. I would do that hike again. I'm gonna get you, baby. So I just got back from my walk. I did 4,289 steps just now. Yeah, I would say that was a pretty good amount of walking. I walk pretty slow in the mornings when I do go for a walk. I'm not trying to be fast. That is not my go, honey. But right now it is 8:23, so I'm gonna take a shower, make breakfast, show you guys that, and then get this day started. So my lips are doing a lot better. They're not as like cracked or chapped because I've been putting A&D on them. They still are a teensy bit swollen. And it's not like so much here swollen, it's more like it's protruding out swollen in like the center of my lip. So yeah, that is currently what I'm dealing with, but it doesn't hurt to like open my mouth anymore, whereas the previous days it did. So, and I think it's just because I kept my mouth closed a little bit more and then just slathered A&D all over my lips along with Neosporin and then just like not moving my mouth as wide, which is really helpful, but it makes me feel like I have plastic surgery because I can feel how swollen my lips are. And it doesn't even feel like my lips are my lips. It's the weirdest thing. But anyway, I did those two workouts from Mr. and Mrs. Muscle, which I really like that full body workout. It is really, really good. It makes me feel really strong. So I'm definitely gonna keep that one for sure in the rotation and check out the rest of their full body workout like videos, because they have like a playlist for each type that they do. They're very well organized on their YouTube channel, like extremely organized, which is amazing. You guys should for sure follow them. Please follow them, subscribe to them on YouTube because they're just amazing, Mr. and Mrs. Muscle. So I'm having my green juice, my celery juice with collagen powder peptides and my oatmeal. That is today's breakfast, like always.
You may drop dead. Hello?
Yeah.
Hello? I'm not wishing that after I ask, Lord, please don't.
So, yesterday we know that I had a tough mental day. And today, I had some meetings that just gave me really good news and really helped me get out of that slump and become more positive. So I'm feeling a lot better. And also because I weigh myself every day and I know what I weigh. This morning I weighed myself because the past couple days have been maintaining for whatever reason. Well, I think it's because like I just ate extra protein because I was just like craving food and just wanting to eat more of it. So that probably explains why like I maintained instead of lost anything, but the scale finally moved down this morning, so that makes me excited for tomorrow, and I feel really good about tomorrow's like weigh-in, which makes me excited for Saturday's weigh-in. I do want to treat myself though to something because I'm like excited, and like having one little treat won't hurt me, but still. I treated myself to some sushi because it's $5 Wednesdays at Sprouts, but I mean, those are just for regular rolls. This is like a chef special, so. Just got back from my walk. I did like a 30-minute walk this morning. I was just like, well, I worked out yesterday morning, and then on odd days, you know, I walk, and I've been walking a lot this week, which has been really good, but this morning I could have walked longer, but my face is still very frozen. It's a nice fall, crisp morning, but like when you're in the shade, which I was in a lot of shade when I was walking, it's a lot colder. So I need to travel with like my little cowl neck thing and gloves because I do not want to get sick. I don't want to get no common cold. because, you know, little sniffles and stuff like that. So yeah, I'm gonna go take a shower now and then get ready. I just went to go check the mail and I finally got my acid kicking minerals from Get Off Your Acid / Alkamind. I'm really excited to try this. You're supposed to take it daily in the evenings is what they suggest. So it's supposed to help improve better sleep, improve focus, workout recovery, reduce cravings, alleviate stress, but also helping fight acid as well. So that's like one of the main reasons why I got it. The other ones were like protein powders or stuff that you could add to your coffee, and I just wanted something that was just to help with my acidity, and this was the closest thing. So I'm glad that it has like other benefits as well. And the flavor is natural lemon flavor. So we shall see. This thing only has 30 servings per container and you just use one scoop. And it's a very small scoop because, as you can see, it is not that big, this bottle thing. So I'm gonna start taking these in the evenings before I go to bed. And then we'll see how I get on with these. It tastes kind of sickly sweet. Kind of. I don't know if I like it. We'll see how this goes.
It kind of tastes like the lemon lime Gatorade, but a little bit different. And I guess because it is more of like a natural flavor, it just tastes different. Because with Gatorade, they do add like a lot of sugars and things that are not good for you in there. And this brand, Alkamind, seems to be very clean and not putting like harsh stuff into your body. So it seems to be like very clean ingredients that you're getting from your powders. I will keep you guys posted on like how, if I feel like my sleep is a lot better or if I feel more energized, because it's supposed to help aid with like brain health and all that stuff. So I will definitely keep you guys updated on how I get on with that. So this morning was a little stressful because I had a meeting early and just ran into a lot of technical difficulties, which is interesting because like I'm usually able to fix those, but when they're happening to you in the moment when you like need things to work, it's not ideal. Anyways, I am having my oatmeal that looks like mush, but it's so freaking delicious. I ran out of bananas yesterday, so I need to go get some today. Kefir this morning, so for sure gonna pick some up at Trader Joe's today. Have my celery juice with collagen peptides. I will say, I feel like that supplement, the Alkamind minerals thing, gives me dry mouth. I feel like it makes sense why people have said like you're gonna drink a lot of water on this, because it gave me dry mouth last night. We'll see how that goes. I have not been like drinking a lot of water recently as much as I normally do. So hopefully when I'm more hydrated, I don't have that issue, but we'll see. Also, it's getting colder and I'm a mouth sleeper, but typically I don't get dry mouth. Like, I don't feel it like that.
And lunch is prepared. Can you see? So I have shrimp, green beans, carrots, and I have an egg under there with goat cheese. So that is today's lunch.
I got pizza.
Anyways, I have pizza in the oven, as you guys saw. I'm gonna have a couple slices
And that's where it's going to end. And then we'll weigh in tomorrow. So I figured I would like pizza, but it's hard to get pizza from other places because they just don't have like vegan options. And it's like the portion is a lot better from Daya anyway, because it's a pretty small pizza. I think it's like 6 to 8 inches. So that's my last update for this evening, and I will see you guys tomorrow for the weigh-in as well as what I'm gonna eat tomorrow.
It is currently 7:30 in the morning. I'm whispering because Melanie is still asleep. Hopefully you can hear me, but I've been up for like an hour and I can't sleep anymore, so I'm just gonna go for a walk to help wake me up. And the sun is just starting to rise. It's so beautiful. Anyways, I'll check in with you guys later when I get back from my walk.
All right, so I weigh 216, which is very exciting and love, love, love so much. I came back from my walk. I'm like dressed, have like jeans on with my Saucony's dress shirt and like little rain jacket because it's a little chilly outside. But I went to Trader Joe's and picked up some food, so I'm gonna show you guys that now. So this is my food haul, which is kind of all over the place, but I got 2 things of peanut butter. Doesn't hurt to always have that on stock. More kefir because I ran out. I got some more snack options, so I got some seaweed. I got these dehydrated carrots and plantain chips, Wisconsin chips. I ran out of umami seasoning, as I stated before, so I got some more of that. And just to like add different fruit, because strawberries are pretty acidic, and I just noticed that like my acid reflux was not getting better with having them in my oatmeal. So I'm gonna switch to blueberries, and I got the frozen one because they're cheaper. And plus, I can just put them in while the oatmeal is cooking, so they'll kind of get soft and nice. And obviously bananas, because bananas are really good. I got 2 things of garlic herb chicken sausage and some raw sunflower seeds unsalted with some coconut flakes. And I'm going to try this harvest grain salad. It has savory grains with butternut squash, cranberries, kale, and pecans in a harvest spice dressing. It says that it does not contain any milk at all, so I felt good about that. And then protein, I got shrimp. Got this shrimp here, so excited to have that. And some smoked salmon, so I'll probably have that later on today. But that is the food haul, because I have enough frozen vegetables, so I don't need any vegetables for right now at least. But yeah, this is what I got. Having the bravocado bowl. Currently eating a little bit of some smoked salmon with some of this harvest grain salad. I'm not gonna have a lot of it because I'm about to have dinner soon, but I just need something to kind of hold me over, and I'm watching Meg squats on YouTube. So I didn't have a lot of that salad. It's extremely cold, which obviously, yeah, salad is cold. Like, I get that. But it's just not tasty. So I had more of the smoked salmon. I had more of the smoked salmon. And yeah, that is all I had. So I'm just gonna leave it there, and then I will check in with you guys for dinner. So, just finishing a Gatorade. I think Mel is gonna be back shortly, and then we're getting Shake Shack. I'm so excited to get Shake Shack. I'm probably gonna get a chicken sandwich with a lettuce wrap situation, and then fries. Ooh, that looks so good.
I'm not sure of what I see. Cupid, don't fuck with me. Are you telling me this is a sign?
telling me this is a sign.